We study food webs using models which describe networks of food chains among different species to better understand and predict what happens in nature.
We illustrate these networks by using spheres to represent the species found in the food web and by using long skinny cones to represent the feeding relationships between these species. Plants are at the base of the food web at the first trophic level. Herbivores are above the plants at the second level, and carnivores of herbivores are above herbivores at the third trophic level, and so on. Omnivores eat species at more than one trophic level. When plants use light energy in the form of sunshine to breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen, they maintain and often increase their own carbon-based plant biomass. When animals use food energy in the form of biomass to breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide, they maintain and often increase their own carbon-based animal biomass. In this visualization, the amount of biomass of each of the species is represented by the size of the spheres. The rate at which species eat each other is represented by the size of the cones. Notice how much the abundance and feeding rates of these interacting species change as they maintain a dynamic balance of nature that keeps all the species present from going extinct to zero biomass, and from undergoing population explosions to infinite biomass. All ecosystems and all habitats are made up of such food webs of breathing, eating, and getting eaten organisms. When species go extinct, or when new species invade an ecosystem, the balance of nature can be upset, causing population explosions and more extinctions. This can also affect how much oxygen and carbon dioxide is consumed and produced, which can in turn affect the temperature of Earth and the severity of global warming.